G'day guys, Viv here again from Battle Bunker. I've had a couple of requests from a few people to make a little tutorial video about the tables that I've built for the club here. So that's what I'm going to be showing in this video. There will be a couple of other things coming down the track, a few requests on how to build churches, a few requests on, again, a long time back on how I make my hills, texturing, sculpting and flocking the hills, more industrial terrain, and a few other projects I can't recall off the top of my head. But in this video, it's not going to be too long, just a real quick summary of how I build my tables. In the description on your right hand side will be the cut lists for the wood that I use, so you can take that cut list to your local timber yard and they should be able to make all the cuts and just cut it for you, so it's nice and quick and simple. So let's go and have a look at the materials that I'll be using. I'll show you a table that's finished so you know what we're going to build, then we'll get into how we go about it. So thanks again to all the new subscribers. We've almost hit 400. When I get to 500, I will start running competitions for scenery and giveaways and all that sort of stuff from my website. Don't forget to check it out. It's www.battlebunker.com. Go join our forums, participate in the discussions. I've been a little bit slack in being involved in those, so I've got to make sure I get back involved in those. So thanks again for watching, and I hope you enjoy the video. Thanks. Okay, so this is an example of a table that I'm going to build. This one is 6 foot by 4 foot. It is just four legs, the other one you can't see, and four rails. The rails I've raised a little bit so dice don't fall off the table. And this table actually comes out for easy movement of the table, etc. So I'm going to show you how to build one of these tables. Yeah, there's a lot of scenery on that table. I just dumped everything on there just before. Anyway, beside the point. So this is the table. There is one crossbeam underneath. The join up there in the corner, nice and easy. And then two supports at either end, just to support the table in the middle. And that crossbeam, as I mentioned before. The table's quite secure like this. It does rock a little bit. Don't know if you can see that rocking while I shake the camera. But nice and quick and simple. So we're gonna have a quick look how I do that. All we need for this, and in this case I'm gonna do this 4x4 table. So this is 4 foot by 4 foot. You need your tabletop. You need a couple of horses or trestles or whatever to make your cuts and all that sort of stuff on. Your leg pieces, now these have all been cut to size, and your struts for the side. You'll also need some screws. Everything will be in the description there, as well as instructions on the forum, and I'll link in the description there as well to the forum so you can see the photos and read through the text. Okay, so I like to work on a flat surface. I'm in my shop here because it's Sunday and I'm open, so I'm going to build this here right in front of my front door, which is probably not a great idea, but it's the flattest surface. If you did this on the carpet moves, it's soft. You could do this in your garage or in your driveway, etc. I like to put down some supports. Now these supports that I'm putting down, this width here is going to be the same width or height of the lip on the end on the side of the table, and you'll see that come together. So there's the supports. Then down on top of that, I put the table. Now I do this on the floor on a flat surface so everything is square. From here, with my pre-cut timbers, I go around and I just wrap each of the sides. So I'm going to get the other pieces and lay them down here, and then we'll talk about screwing everything together. Okay, so once you've got your supports down, your table on top of that, you want to just line your side walls along the edge. Now, when you look at the cut list, you'll notice that there's two pieces that are the same length and two other pieces that are a slightly longer length. That way, when you wrap them around, you'll get a nice flush corner here through which we're going to put our screws. If all of the pieces were the same length, when you put them on there, you'll end up with a gap like that, which makes it very difficult to secure these two pieces together. So this is the way I'm going to do it. I mean, there's hundreds of ways you can do this, but this is one of the easiest ways that I've found.
Once we get to this page, our stage, now we need to start getting our drills out, drilling holes and screwing stuff. So we'll see that shortly.
Okay, so now we're at the stage where we need to take our drill and start drilling our holes in the edges here to be able to secure these two pieces together. So I'm using 8-gauge screws. They're 38mm timber screws, 38mm long. It's an 8-gauge screw. That's how thick it is. So I've got the appropriate drill bit in my drill. I put two screws, one in here, on both sides. I put one at the top and one sort of at the middle. Keep in mind that we're going to put a beam in here and screws from this side, so you need to allow room for the other screws to go through without hitting. So one at the top and one down the bottom there. If you're using self-tapping screws, then you probably don't need to drill your hole. I am using, these will sink their own hole, but I'm going to drill the pilot hole anyway. It just makes it easier for things to go together. Line up your edges. Drill your first hole. Now this is where I've got to start messing around with my drill, taking the drill bit out. If you have one of those U-Butte drills where you can take the chuck off the top and put on a second chuck with your screwdriver bit in it, then no problems. But otherwise, so I'm going to go through and do all of these holes like this. Bear with me while I put this back in. So I drill one hole and then I put the screw in and drive the screw home. Oops, that's a little fast. Brilliant. Then I take my chuck out and do the other hole and keep on going around the table. So they're the first ones. That'll put all of our pieces together. No need to show you the whole process because it gets quite boring. And then change out our bit again. So this is my dilemma, having to do this every time. You could drill all your holes first and then put all your screws in, but I just prefer to do it like this, just in case I get one of the holes wrong or something like that. All right, cool. So I'll come back once I've put all of these together. If you haven't guessed already, I'm building the table upside down. So one leg's gonna go in there. We're gonna fasten it from this side. One or two screws through this side, and then three screws through this side. And again, you'll be able to see on the forum all the pictures of this. It will make a little bit more sense that way. So I'm gonna go through and do all of these legs, putting three screws in one side and two screws in the other. Check the forums for the details.
Okay, so I've got all four of the legs done. You can see these are pretty secure. And if you build it on a flat floor like this, you're not really going to have to worry about keeping things too square. As long as you hold the timbers while you're putting things together, it should be fine. Next step is to put this brace through the middle so the table doesn't flex. And simply I'm going to just use a little L bracket there to secure it in place. On the bigger tables, I did put a little chunk of wood here. I don't know if it will be necessary on this one. I'll put this together and see what it's like. So once I've done that, I'll come back, we'll flip the table over, and then it'll be time to paint it. Okay, so both chocks are in, that one and that one. One thing you want to be aware of, and I'll point it out in the forum, sorry about the light there guys, is when you're putting your table down and you've got your chocks underneath, you need the chock sitting in the corner. Now the table's upside down, this is where the chock would be sitting. You can see the height here is very different than the height over there. So that was my stuff up. I had the chalk sitting in the wrong place. Read the forum and it will show you more. Now you can paint this whatever color you want to paint it. Then your tabletop just simply slips inside. Look. You could paint one side of your tabletop like I have here green, and the other side of the tabletop grey. Fantasy 40K. Anyway guys, thanks for watching. I hope it's been fun.